Virginia Citizenship Educators. That's Julie Glasper. I would like to introduce our reviewers to you today. So we have Christina Vega, Assistant Director of Attorney and Story Life at the University of Vermont. V. Vargas, Coordinator of Attorney and Story Life at the University of Vermont. And then Brandon Majumar, Graduate Advisor of Attorney and Story Life at the University of Vermont. And then today for support, we have William Cangelosi, Graduate Assistant of Attorney and Story Life at SUNY Plattsburgh. Alison Swick-Dudney, Director of Attorney and Story Life at SUNY Plattsburgh. And then Jack Hines and Kelsey Ken, who are the incoming Fraternal Officership
Directors.
Jake. Oh my goodness. And I would like to introduce the eighth of the day, Taka Swan.
Hello everyone, my name is David McMahon and I'm the current president of Talk at Epsilon and I've been a member since fall of 2016.
Hello everybody, my name is Brian Marino. I've been a member of Talk at Epsilon since spring 2017 and I'm the current risk management.
My name is Trevor Peck, I'm the current member educator of Talk at Epsilon and I've been a member since last fall.
Good afternoon everyone, I am Corey Rock. This is actually my first semester as a member of Talk at Epsilon.
Hello, my name is Fazio Michelle, I'm the current secretary. Talk up of the Super Game Chapter, Talk Up of Salon, and I got the Spring 17.
So today we're going to give you a quick overview of what it means to be a Talk Up of Salon, our mission as members of Talk Up of Salon, what it means to break the stigma of being a part of the Greek life community for people who don't know, our continued dedication to the Plattsburgh community, and how we use our six pillars to evolve, inform our daily lives. So this is the mission statement of Talk Cap Epsilon. It is to aid men in their mental, moral, and social development for life. We believe that this is important because advancing character and personal development unlocks the potential of men to be great college students, college graduates, and also productive members of society. Here at SUNY Plattsburgh, we understand that college is only one rung on your personal ladder to success, and we also believe ourselves, the Talk at Epsilon has prepared all of us to maximize that success.
I'll talk to you about the frat versus fraternity issue. The majority of people that aren't associated with Greek life or to what Greek life entails always abbreviate the word fraternity to frat. The term frat has an extremely negative connotation to it, to which people directly associate members of fraternities to popularize movies such as Animal House, as well as a great deal exclusively based solely upon one's own social status. However, the term fraternity has two definitive meanings. It is defined as either a group of people sharing a common profession or interests, as well as the state or feeling of friendship and mutual support within a group. As members of Talk Cap Epsilon, we strive to bury negative stereotypes pertaining to fraternities, as our founders had once originally created their fraternity to do so. We proudly have brothers from all walks of life, ethnic backgrounds, religious affiliations, and illustrious members of the LGBTQ community. We value our members not for their wealth or rank, but for their personal worth and character. When we were founded in 1899, our founders created six pillars for us to uphold in our everyday lives: service, scholarship, character, leadership, brotherhood, and teamwork. These are facets of our everyday lives that encapsulate who we are as men and will continue to follow us throughout our entire lives.
So, Talk Cap Epsilon is really dedicated to service. It's one of our six pillars. Each of our members are actually mandated to do at least 10 hours of community service per semester. Additionally, the chapter each semester votes on one service initiative that all members must attend. The Sigma Gamma chapter of Talk Cap Epsilon actually has a per-member average of community service hours higher than the SUNY Plattsburgh campus average.
We personally believe in community service as one of the things that's been intrinsically founded in our chapter since the beginning, since we've been refounded recently. About 5 or 6 years ago, when our group of students here was trying to refound the chapter, originally the chapter here, more than 10 years ago at this point, they've been getting together, and one day, years ago, the lake over there in Champlain was having some flooding, and there's a group of apartment buildings at risk of being flooded. So there's a group of people who are at risk of losing their homes to the water coming in. So one of our founders, Greg Halloran, and a group of guys went over there and spent 11 hours. actually managing to save people's homes. Greg Howard is actually now working for the National Fraternity as a risk management, and he's been very helpful in keeping our chapter going.
These same principles can be seen each and every week within our chapter. Our service chair every week is allotted a certain amount of time for people to speak about each event opportunity that we have throughout the week. We actually created a system where we're broken down into two separate teams, once for Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, once for Tuesday, Thursdays, and Saturdays, which we are mandated to sign up for at least one event to go to each and every week, so that we are very efficient with how we do our service.
Our main point to be here at Talk Out Epsilon to say you should appreciate it. For honor, Danny Thomas, a brother of Talk Out Epsilon, was the original founder of St. Jude Shulamit Research Hospital, and that is why it is our main philanthropy. All the money we raise goes towards the research and development of treatments for childhood cancer. Up here are some of the major events we participate in over the academic year that help us raise money for our cause. First, we have TeakSaw, which is an event we hold in front of the ACC, where the brothers go up and down on the T-Saw for 48 hours. Each hour represents 1 year that St. Jude Shulamit Research Hospital has been open. Currently it's 56, but we are only allowed 48 hours in front of the ACC, so we do as much as we can. And with that, the seesaw is a symbol for us at St. Jude's Research Hospital tipping the scales against childhood cancer.
The next event that we take part in as members of Talk Out Epsilon is Up Till Dawn. We know that this is done all across the nation at different colleges, but here we take a special interest. We continually send brothers to be members of the executive board, like this past Up Till Dawn, where a brother was the executive director, and we also had an additional member on the executive board that helped set up.
Applause for a Cause is another event that we do. This one's really good for getting us involved with other Greek life on campus. We hold this in the coffee house, and it's like an open mic night where everyone goes, have fun, and it helps us raise some money for some fees.
As for Teak in a Box, it is one of our main philanthropy events that occurs in front of the ACC. Brothers reside in the box night and day for a period of 48 hours. In order to collect perishables, charitable donations such as money, and they directly aid the Salvation Army. We are currently looking to ways to aid other philanthropies via this event as well.
Another fun one that we have usually at the end of the year is called Car Smash. What happens is a local junkyard will donate two or broken down cars for us, and they'll drag them out right behind us in the NBC Plaza. And then we let people pay to smack it with a sledgehammer or a baseball bat. It's a lot of fun, and we raise a lot of money for it. We raise $100 doing that, and gets everyone excited to do it.
Now, typically that money goes through St. Jude's. However, last year we sent that money for the hurricane relief with the timing.
So from the start of the whole academic year, our chapter is over $5,005 for St. Jude's Research Hospital. So
for leadership within Talk Out Epsilon, we have multiple brothers that hold leadership positions within the campus community. Frater Daniel Hashkapazi serves as the Vice President of Diversity within the Student Association, and has aided in a great deal of new legislation to create a safer environment for a diverse community. Frater Brandon Collins served as IFC's VP of Standards to hold the Greek community in high regard. Frater Fawzi Animashan holds the position of Secretary within NAVA, and perhaps he can tell you more than I can about the association and what it entails.
So currently I am the Secretary of the National Association of Black Accountants. What we do is basically give opportunities for minors in terms of getting jobs, getting clothing, getting up with their resumes, just to help them build themselves professionally as a whole.
We have a new member who is also active within the collegiate athletics, Father Corey Rump.
Yes, I currently run track and field for Plattsburgh State, and a lot of the principles such as discipline that I have been learning throughout Talk Out Epsilon have directly translated to help me succeed in track and field. We also host multiple different intramural sports that we do that partake in as well.
Father Michael Spagnolo has held a position as an RA within the campus housing and residential life for over 2 years. We have a great deal of members that are involved in the Plattsburgh community, only further strengthening our motto, better men for a better world.
All right, one of our proudest things in our new member education program. So for potential new members, we'd like to hold them to a very high standard and make sure they become very active PISC members of the college community. We recommend that they have library hours logged to
Children's Museum and helped out with an event they were having. I think it was a really fulfilling time, and I think everyone had a lot of fun. Also, we also recommended they spend time getting to know each of the brothers of fraternity before they become initiated members so that they can be the best that they possibly can be when they get in.
And one final thing about that, to continue our development as members when we are initiated. The national organization provides us with this tool called Blueprint. It's an online learning service where you go on your own time and you fill out activities and learning lessons that kind of teach you everything that you need to know about being a college student, how to manage your time, how to build a resume, even things like how to change your oil. Basically, it just prepares you for life, and we feel that that's something very important in our chapter.
Okay. So we're going to be moving on to the question and answer session. So if anyone has
Can you tell us a little bit about how financial management shows up in your chapter?
Yep, I can speak on that. Actually, something that we didn't get to reach, but I can talk about now is RLC. It's a regional leadership conference. Along with RLC, we also attend other conferences, such as PEC, which stands for Provisional Education Conference. And there we get to learn from other chapters at our national organization and instructors that they provide a bunch of lessons on how to do things like manage our finances. And when I actually attended RLC this February, I was in a seminar for finance where they introduced programs that could help members pay dues or how to properly build a payment plan that it can be effective and not just a way to punish members, to a way to actually encourage and help them. That's something that I feel is very beneficial.
You talked a little bit about your library hours, but in terms of scholarship, can you talk a little bit about academic support for membership chapters?
Yeah. I can also talk about this one. That's another thing that we didn't get to go to, but this semester our new e-board has really tried to rework our academic program because we have realized that academics are something that are very important and we may have been slacking on them in the past. And to rework this, our scholarship chairs actually divided all our members by major so that they have proper support. And then through this, they're mandated to do a certain amount of library hours. Also meet bi-weekly to talk about tests that they may have had, questions on homeworks. And also it's a way to kind of push members and provide support that they will seek out help from an academic advisor if needed, because we know that sometimes it's embarrassing if you have bad grades and you always don't have the most confidence. But if your brothers are there supporting you, we have seen that it tends to help people want to help themselves.
This is a very beneficial system also with the brothers who have taken classes before, with brothers that are in classes now. For example, myself being in managerial accounting, being one of the classes that I'm better at, being a finance major. Within this group, say next semester somebody's taking that same class, when we meet bi-weekly, I'll be able to help out anyone with that class that they may have questions for.
Just to
talk and just see what's going on in each other's lab. Labs and that's how it goes.
The cooking events as well. And you all have a great time. Dan and his chicken farm.
Can you tell me a little bit about how standards and how they show up in tractor?
Yeah, I can talk about that. Internally, we have something called a membership quality board. And I actually sit on that board as president. And we allow two members at large, and also our new member educator, and another member of our e-board to sit on that. And what we do is we meet bi-weekly with members who we feel are at risk academically, socially, or have been referred to us by other brothers for complaints that they may have had in any type of situation. And at those meetings, we kind of identify the problem, we talk about it, we assess what the right solution will be, and then we implement it, and then we follow up with that afterwards. And if it's working, we're all good. If it doesn't, we reassess and reevaluate.
Can you talk a little bit about your relationship with alumni and advisors?
Yeah. One thing that I'm actually most proud of with this chapter is that we do keep really good relationships with alumni. Members who have recently graduated in the fall semester who haven't yet left Plattsburgh, they're always come to chapter. Graduate students, we hold alumni events because our alumni, they participate in curling. And once yearly, there's a curling tournament up here that they come up for, and we go down and we support them. And we also have a number of alumni who live in Vermont. And when we do have brotherhood events, we invite them to come. Meet the newer brothers, reconnect with the ones that they haven't seen in a while. And in terms of with our advisor, I meet with him bi-weekly, where we discuss all the things that are going on with the chapter, anything that may arise, any problems that we may have. We also invite him to all our philanthropy and service events, and when he can't, he attends, he comes to us philanthropy and service with us.
I also have a question. So I think you all talked about 10 hours being in the group, but then also there's a weekly event in terms of service that folks have to attend. Are you seeing if brothers are doing more than 10 hours? And have you thought about breaking that number if that's the case?
Yeah, so typically many people are doing more than 10 hours. However, that's just our minimum standards that we have. The team-based thing that we implement goes above and beyond just community service as well. Many different organizations will be putting on seminars throughout the week and different events and fundraisers, and this is another way to help us gain some attendance at those and help raise some money for other causes, other philanthropies that different organizations are bringing.